If you've ever watched an air show, you can see pilots performing aerobatic performance. They showcase their technical skills and stamina with amazing feats everywhere in the skies. There are various categories of aerobatic maneuvers you'll see at such shows. These include horizontal and vertical lines, loops, rolls, spins, stall turns, and many more. Aerial performers combine these moves in complex choreographed sequences. Of course, supermaneuverable aircraft can do a lot of these stunts. Thrust vectoring and thrust to weight ratio plays an important role for these incredible maneuvers. So today, the buzz will present the 8 incredible types of maneuvers. And if you have your favorite flight maneuver, please drop in the comment section below. Cuban 8 maneuvers. This is an aerobatic maneuver by an airplane consisting of 3/4 of a normal loop, a half roll, 3/4 of another normal loop, and another half roll, followed by recovery from the dive to straight level flight. By placing a half roll on each of the descending 45-degree lines, the pilot is able to fly a horizontal without performing an outside loop. This type of maneuver is said to have been invented by Len Povey, an American pilot who had served with the Cuban Air Force. He executed this maneuver somewhat by accident in 1936 at the All-American Air Race meeting in Miami. This maneuver is said to be one of the most complex, which requires concentration to assure precision of form, airspeed, and altitude. Up next, we have the Tailslide maneuver. This is basically just a Pugachev Cobra, taking its sweet time. The pilot would stunt in the same way he does in a Cobra, but instead of pitching forward right away to recover, he merely sits there for a few moments. A fighter jet which has a high thrust-to-weight ratio can basically let it hover stalled out at a near-vertical angle for an incredibly long period, and it stays in that position for a while before it falls forward all the way into a steep dive to transition back into an aerodynamic flight. While this is a tough trick that requires post-stall control, it isn't completely limited to supermaneuverable jets. Next, we have the flat spin maneuver. A flat spin is an aerodynamic condition during a flight in which aircraft's nose pitches up due to tail loading and the plane begins to descend from the sky in a rotating motion with no forward speed. Flat spins are the worst and most dangerous type of spin. In a flat spin, the aircraft has no forward airspeed. As it sinks straight to the earth, it spins around its vertical axis. The flight controls are ineffective because there is no forward airspeed as said. The pilot effectively has no way to correct for the spin and is totally unrecoverable. Next, we have the Kvochur's bell maneuver. Kvochur's bell maneuver is a variation where the aircraft propels forward almost vertically while simultaneously braking and following the movement of its tail. At the Farnborough Air Show in 1988, Anatoly Kvochur, a Soviet test pilot, was the first to fly the Bell Tailslide in a MiG-29. The word bell perfectly describes this aerobatic figure. The plane draws a bell pendulum motion in the sky. First, the aircraft nose goes up at zero speed and then falls backwards down. Next is the falling leaf. The falling leaf maneuver, also called a rudder stall or oscillation stall, is a maneuver in which an aircraft performs a stall that causes it to spin. A falling leaf is a controlled stall performed in a fixed-wing aircraft. The maneuver is performed by purposely stalling the airplane and then carefully using the rudder to try to hold the aircraft on a steady course. As the speed drops, the pilot holds the plane as level as possible in both the longitudinal direction and lateral direction. When the stall speed is reached, the plane will lose lift and begin to fall. The falling leaf is often used as a training maneuver, teaching the pilot to control the plane during a stall and helping beginners to overcome the fear that happens when a plane stalls unexpectedly. Up next is the Herbst maneuver, also known as a J-turn. The Herbst maneuver was first performed by an X-31 on April 29, 1993. Dr. Wolfgang Herbst, a Messerschmitt Balkobaum employee, provided the inspiration for the Herbst maneuver. This maneuver is basically Pugachev's Cobra with a bit of a twist. The Herbst maneuver requires the pilot to roll the plane a little while its nose is pointed at the sky, so that when the nose comes down, the plane is oriented in a different direction. Though categorized with Pugachev's Cobra, which is popular at air shows, the Herbst maneuver is considered more useful in combat. Up next, we have the Cobra maneuvers or Pugachev Cobra. The Cobra maneuver is an example of supermaneuverability, specifically post-stall maneuvering. It is a fast vertical pitch-up from level flight without commencing a climb, followed by a forward pitch-back to level flight. The plane maintains almost straight flight during the maneuver if done correctly. The plane does not roll or yaw in either direction. The maneuver relies on the plane's ability to change angle of attack quickly without overloading the airframe, and sufficient engine thrust to maintain nearly constant altitude through the entire move, but also post-stall stability and aerodynamics that allow for the recovery to level flight. Fighter jets which have done this type of maneuver include Saab 35 Draken, MiG-21, Sukhoi Su-27, Sukhoi Su-57, and the MiG-29. Lastly, we have the Kulbit, also known as the Frol of Chakra, is an aerial maneuver developed by Russian pilots in which the aircraft performs an extremely tight loop, often not much wider than the aircraft's length. It varies from the standard inner loop as it employs supermaneuverability or post-stall maneuvering skills. The Kulbit maneuvers reduces the speed of the aircraft dramatically, and it might conceivably be employed to cause a chasing aircraft to miss its target. The maneuver is similar to the well-known Pugachev's Cobra, but the Kulbit completes the loop that the Cobra breaks off nearly immediately. Fighter jets which have done this type of maneuver include the F-22 Raptor, Sukhoi Su-57, Sukhoi Su-35, Sukhoi Su-30, Sukhoi Su-37, and the MiG-29 OVT. We hope you've enjoyed today's video. If you did, don't forget to hit that notification and subscribe button for more videos from the buzz. Thank you guys for viewing in. Bye-bye.